The US Air Force has, for the first time, deployed robotic dogs to guard its military facilities. This is part of the new Advanced Battle Management System, ABMS, a digital battle network allowing forces to accumulate, process, and share data in real time. Viewers may note that the dogs had demonstrated their capabilities in a large-scale test exercise in September held in Nellis Air Force Base and have proved their worth. As per reports, the dogs are currently being used to guard Nellis Air Force Base in southern Nevada, which houses more squadrons than any other American base in the world, as well as Tyndall Air Force Base in Florida. Named the Q-UGV, Quadrupedal Unmanned Ground Vehicle, the dogs are assigned to carry out tasks that include remote inspection, intelligence, surveillance, reconnaissance, ISR, mapping, and distributed communications. The dogs are data connected, which allows them to communicate with other systems seamlessly. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how Q-UGV robotic dog will protect U.S. military bases. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by War Thunder. If you are, like us, fascinated by military vehicles and technology, I recommend you give War Thunder a try. It's a military vehicle combat game, which you can download and play for free on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One, with cross-platform support. It has a huge variety of more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s, which you can take to battle on land, in the air, and at sea on more than 80 theaters of war. War Thunder's been kind enough to offer all Defense Updates viewers a special bonus, which will grant you a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time for registering using our link in the description below. So take the plunge and join more than 20 million players from around the world. The U.S. military has by far the most number of bases, despite recently closing hundreds of bases in Iraq and Afghanistan. The United States maintains nearly 800 military bases in more than 70 countries and territories abroad. Many of these bases house important and expensive assets, some of them being strategic ones like B-2 Spirit Bomber. A single B-2 costs around $2 billion. A simple grenade lobbed onto the aircraft could potentially cripple it. This will not only lead to huge financial loss, but degradation in U.S. combat capability. Militaries around the world have experienced attacks on their bases and centers. On the 16th of July 2015, four Marines and a sailor were killed by Kuwait-born Muhammad Youssef Abdulaziz, age 24, of Hickson, Tennessee, who opened fire at a recruiting center in Chattanooga. On the 2nd of January 2016, a heavily armed group attacked the Pathankot Air Force Station, part of the Western Air Command of the Indian Air Force. In the attack, seven security personnel were killed, and the base also suffered damages. On the 7th of October 2019, a man rammed a stolen truck into a barricade at Naval Air Station Corpus Christi in South Texas, and then ran around the base with a stolen handgun before he was arrested. As per some reports, between late February and early March of last year, Anderson Air Force Base on the island of Guam experienced repeated incursions by unmanned aircraft. The war zone reported that the intruding craft was described as quadcopter-like vehicles with bright spotlights that flew from over the water and then across the northwest base. Surveillance activities such as this could be a precursor for an impending attack. Clearly, the protection of bases needs special attention. Major Jordan Chris from Tyndall stated in an official release, "These robot dogs will be used as a force multiplier for enhanced situational awareness by patrolling areas that aren't desirable for human beings and vehicles." He added further, "We will be able to drive them via a virtual reality headset within our base defense operations center. We will be able to see exactly what the robot dog is detecting through its mobile camera and sensor platform if desired. We will also be able to issue verbal commands to a person or people through a radio attached to the dogs." It's important to note that currently these dogs have no combat capabilities. There are reports that the Pentagon is considering inducting combat-capable four-legged robots into service. Q-UGV, with its reconnaissance role, is just the first one, and is likely that more capable robots will enter service going forward. The specific model being deployed is known as Vision 60. The maker, Ghost Robotics, calls the Vision 60 a Q-UGV, or Quadrupedal Unmanned Ground Vehicle. Ghost Robotics' website states, "Ghost Robotics is revolutionizing legged robotics, and the market for highly agile and fast teleoperated and autonomous unmanned ground vehicles, UGVs, for military, homeland security, public safety, and enterprise applications. Our quadrupedal UGVs, Q-UGV, are unstoppable. Beyond all-terrain stability and operation in unstructured environments, a core design principle for our legged robots is reduced mechanical complexity when compared to other legged robots, and even traditional wheeled tracked UGVs. By reducing complexity, we inherently increase durability, agility, and endurance, and reduce the cost to deploy and maintain ground robots. Our modular design supports field maintenance and parts replacement within minutes. Strategic partners can build solution-specific QUGVs for virtually any use case with their choice of sensors, radios, and even size the robot to suit specific requirements by licensing our reference designs. The company also has another variant named Spirit 40. Service dogs have been employed by militaries across the world to guard their bases and other important installations. Unlike a real service dog, a robotic dog can patrol wider areas since it won't be tired, and also provide the military personnel direct eyes on the ground. It's not hard to see that robotic dogs, like Vision 60, could play a key role in patrolling perimeters of military bases, scouting areas ahead of human soldiers on the battlefield, and inspecting potentially dangerous objects. These robotic dogs could also be used to carry some of the soldiers' equipment, as well as map the surroundings, giving the soldier excellent situational awareness. As the technology matures, the robotic dogs could be employed for passive as well as active combat roles. In passive roles, they could be used to lay landmines, while in active roles, they may be fitted with a gun system or grenade launcher to neutralize enemies. It's undeniable that the potential is huge, and the science fiction of robots working alongside humans is becoming reality quicker than expected. The US military has been one step ahead of its rivals because of its futuristic vision and ability to implement groundbreaking ideas. The deployment of robotic dogs, again, depicts the same values. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.